हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू द स्टडी ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स. इन द लास्ट एपिसोड वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट सम बेसिक टर्म्स ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स. वी जस्ट रिवाइज दैट कॉन्सेप्ट्स रिगार्डिंग द कंज्यूमर्स, प्रोड्यूसर्स, सेलर्स. सो दिस वी स्टडीड इन द लास्ट एपिसोड एंड ऑल्सो definition of Alfred Marshall, ordinary business of life and economic problems. So this also discussed in the previous episode. Dear students, today we'll discuss about the, according to synopsis, another one concept, that is scarcity. Before going to this topic, we'll move on one of the famous story, that is your childhood story regarding the Aladdin and his magic lamp. So that we can see, and this will relate it to the concept of a scarcity. So this is one of the interesting story you heard in your childhood. See, if you ever heard the story of Aladdin and his magic lamp, you would agree that Aladdin was a lucky guy. Do you think why he is a lucky guy? Because whatever he wants, so he gets immediately with the help of Jinn. So that he was one of the lucky guy. Whenever and whatever he wanted, he just had to rub his magic lamp on when a jinn appeared to fulfill his wish. For example, when he wanted a palace to live in, the jinn instantly made one for him. And when he wanted expensive gifts to bring to the king, when asking for his daughter's hand, he got them at the bat of an eyelid. That means whenever he needs, immediately he get the products. So this is what the magic lamp. But is it applied in our real life? Or is it we are lucky as like Aladdin? So that here in real life, we cannot be as lucky as Aladdin, because like him, we have unlimited wants, but we do not have a magic lamp. See, Aladdin also having unlimited wants, but in order to fulfill his wants, he should have what? That is magic lamp. But it is not possible to us because we do not have any kind of a magical lamp. But we are having unlimited wants. How can you say that? For example, the pocket money that you get to spend, if you had more of it, then you can could purchase almost all the things you wanted. Isn't it? But since your pocket money is limited, then you have to choose only those things that you want the most. Say, for one instance, if you are having rupees 2000 in your pocket, then immediately you want to purchase whatever you need. But that 2000 is limited up to only 100 rupees. Then now your wants become, or now your needs become fulfilled only rupees 100. That means your wants become unlimited, but the availability of resource, that means availability of money, that is only rupees 100. So now this situation is linked with our concept, that is what scarcity. Now, why did you not fulfill your all wants or demand? Because there is scarcity. So remember, scarcity is the root of all economic problems. So what is the main root of economic problems? That is scarcity. Scarcity is only the root of all economic problems. Remember, it is all economic problems. So like that, for example, for the growth of plant, so it requires a proper root. Yes, without the root, that plant will not be grow. So like that only. So for all the economic problems, that should be started only because of the scarcity. In our daily life, also we are facing scarcity. Take for example, long queues at railway station, bus stop, theaters, malls, along with the vegetable markets. So like that, we face every day in our life scarcity, as well as the resources like water, the scarcity of water. So this also we face in our daily life. So that all the economic problems can be arise only because of the scarcity. And due to the unlimited wants and limited resources, this is also the reason for scarcity. Now, we'll discuss about economy and its components. A system in which people getting to satisfy their wants to the process of production, consumption, investment, and exchange. So these are all what components in the economy. Now we'll discuss one by one the four components of economy. First one, production. What is production? Production means transformation of input into output. Inputs are land, labor, capital, and organization, as well as which is considered as raw materials, and outputs like ready-made goods or finished goods. Thus, production is conversion of raw materials into finished goods, or it is the transformation of input into output. For example, raw cotton, which is converted into cloth. Or take for example, some agricultural crops. Take for example, sugarcane, which is converted into sugar. So this is what production. And this production, which helps to improve the standard of living, because it gives the employment opportunities, as well as which makes goods and services available to the people. And in economy, we can say that production can helps to increase the export and also increases the wealth of the people. Thus, production can play an important role in the economy. Second one, consumption. Then what is consumption? Consumption means consume the goods. That means whenever we make use of any commodity or service for the satisfaction of our wants, that action or that act is called consumption. For example, when we take a glass of water to quench our thirst, now we are said to be consume the water. Another one example, while sitting on chairs in the classroom, the students are consuming the chairs. And another one example, a person is sick and he calls in a doctor and he has consumed the doctor's service. Thus, whenever we make use of any commodity or services for the satisfaction of our wants, that act is called as consumption. Next, third component, that is investment. In economic sense, an investment is the purchase of goods that are not consumed today but are used in the future because to create wealth. So that is what investment. An investment can also lead to economic growth, that is by the way of increase in investment. While increase in investment, which should boost to economic growth. And this investment helps to make the determination in future growth. And last one, distribution. Then what is distribution? In economics, distribution is the way total output, income or wealth is distributed among individuals or among the factors of production. That means GDP or national income, which is distributed among the four factors of production. Four factors of productions are land, labor, capital and organization. Thus, economics is a branch of social science and which focused on the production, consumption and distribution along with the investment. So these are all the components of economy. Now we'll discuss about factors of production. In the economy, there are four factors of production, that is land, labor, capital and organization or entrepreneurship. So you just see here in this picture, land, labor, that is tractor driver, capital, that is this tractor machine, as well as organization or the entrepreneurship. So that is what this person's idea, this person's thinking. So that is what entrepreneurship. So these are the four factors of a production. So now, in order to make a profit, a person usually needs certain things or certain economic inputs. The economic inputs used to make profit are called factors of a production. Then let me discuss about one by one. First factors of production, that is land. As we know that land is fixed asset. Land is the physical place where economic activity takes place. Land plays an important part in the production because land itself and resources on it are usually limited. It has taken on various forms, from agriculture land to commercial real estate to the resource available from a particular price of a land. National resources such as oil, gold can be extracted and refined for human consumption from the land. So thus we can say that land is one of the fixed factor, natural resource as well as very essential part in the economic system. Second one, labor. Then who is labor? Labor refers to the effort expended by an individual to bring a product or service to the market. For example, the construction worker at a hotel site is a part of labor, as well as waiter who serves guests or the receptionist who enrolls them into the hotel. So these are the labors in different ways. And labor represents all of the people that are available to transform resources into goods or services that can be purchased. This factor is somewhat flexible since different people can be allocated to produce different things. Nobody has to produce everything themselves. That would be impractical. It's also important that labor force is overall educated and well trained to ensure that they can produce goods at peak efficiency and quality. Thus, in the economy, the role of labor, so that is also very important. Third one, factors of production, that is capital. Capital is an important factor of production because it's what allows labor and land to be purchased. Steady streams of capital are often required in order to keep a business going. In economics, capital typically refers to money, but money is not a factor of production because it is not directly involved in producing a goods or service. For modern mainstream economist refers to capital is the primary driver of value, and thus capital is nothing but purchase of goods made with money in production. For example, a tractor purchased for farming is capital, along with desk, chairs used in an office, that is also capital. So in this way, capital also one of the important factor of production. Next one, entrepreneurship or organization. Entrepreneur or organization. It is the secret sauce that combines all the other factors of production into a product or service for the consumer market. It is the drive to develop an idea into a business. And entrepreneur combines the other three factors of production like land, labor and capital to add to supply. And profit is the main motive of every business or every firm. So that a proper entrepreneurship, a proper idea, proper thinking, then easily that firm will achieve success. Ownership of the factors of production depends on the type of economic system and society. So in this way, we can say that each four factors of production are played major role in the economic system. Now we'll move on exercise questions from this episode. First question, what are the four components of economy? Question number two, scarcity is the root of dash. Question number three, what are the factors of production? And question number four, write a note on capital. And last question, why we are not as lucky as Aladdin. So these are the exercise questions of this episode. And everybody compulsorily write in separate A4 sheet paper and completely watch the video. Thank you.